At this press conference of the branch today, Monday, 7th May 2018, we respectfully welcome all to this press conference. We will not tire to praise and appreciate our esteemed partners in the arduous but noble task of nation building, the press, for their long and continuous contribution in this regard. This conference is to address some salient issues of deep public interest germane to the peace and progress of the country. Land Use Charge Law 2018. I believe all of us are aware of the Land Use Charge Law 2018 and its many controversies. The law's notoriety lies in its illegality, unconstitutionality, insensitivity, and harshness, attracting wide-scale opprobrium in the state. The NBA Ikeja branch, as well known, has been at the forefront of the opposition to this cruel and bewildering law. We have held two street protests on 13th and 29th March 2018, and you can see some of the pictures there of the protest actions. We've staged a parliamentary walkout on the 27th March 2018, and we have submitted a hefty 32-page memorandum on it to the Lagos State House of Assembly on 10th April 2018, where we recommend that it is a complete repeal of the obnoxious law. We have commenced town hall meetings and consultations with Lagosians, and it's an ongoing exercise. Nothing much has been heard from the side of the executive arm of government beyond serving notices of payment of the land use charges on Lagos, on Lagosians, and trying to coax out payments from them with very limited success. Please note that earlier in the day, the branch has sent a letter of inquiry to the Lagos State House Assembly about any development in their legislative efforts over the widely unacceptable law. Many have been asking the NBA Ikeja branch over the Land Use Charge 2018, but our message is constant: civil, disciplined, principled disobedience and refusal to honor the illegality. This remains the message of the NBA Ikeja branch, and this is: Lagosians, don't pay the Land Use Charge Law 2018 yet. Don't pay it. That's our message. Threats to the life of NBA Ikeja branch chairman. Since about 7 days now, we have noticed mounted electronic surveillance, quote-unquote, eyes in the sky devices, commonly called drones, over the NBA Ikeja branch secretariat. If you wait till 7:30, you see three of them, one here, one there, and one far off there. It's there. If you wait till 7:30, you see them. The home, that's my home, and the workplace of my humble self as chairman of this great and illustrious branch. On a lighter mood, people used to say you have a monitoring spirit or a guardian angel. In my own case, I have monitoring drones. Drones have been invading my house, this secretariat, my office, and follows me anywhere, and that is the truth. Though it may look fantastic to some of us, but those of you that have been with me to witness, including the vehicle, will attest to this. Clearly, those responsible for the invasion of my privacy, the illegal surveillance, untoward and cowardly harassment is known by government and our agents. And the reason for this abuse of power is petty and at the same time sinister. You will also recall that on the 28th March 2018, Mr. Edgar Limohimi, the Commissioner of Police Lagos State, made a wild, baseless and false accusation against me and other executives during the full-Thai police attempt to truncate our protest march of 29th March 2018, that the leadership of this branch was being sponsored by disgruntled politicians in our opposition to Land Use Charge 2018. the harassment of the leadership of this branch by security agents on behalf of the government is gestapoic and a vindication of our position that our political leaders and those who hold high government offices in Lagos State and in other parts of the country are not Democrats, for they do not understand or appreciate that the dynamics of democracy include a vibrant opposition and principled dissent. A successful democracy does not encourage or enthrone autocracy. The activities of the government against me as chairman and the MP Ikeja branch in particular are utterly unreasonable, for it is tantamount to treating me and my co-leaders as a dangerous, violent criminal terrorist with a record of unleashing mayhem on the society, which is certainly not the case here. We are just the regular Joe, only privileged to lead a progressive and conscientious vow. We have cried out now to alert the public as to this present danger against myself, family members, co-leaders, friends, colleagues, and associates. We knew or we know about the state killings and murders of various persons like Delegiwa Bolaigi, Alfred Ruwani, and the unclear indictment of the Nigerian government in the Dastard Act. Nonetheless, we reiterate our commitment to the struggle at hand, and we are ready to pay the price. And other struggles to come, we urge this government of the state and in Nigeria to think and act more like Jeremy Bentham than murderous discourse like Hitler, Mobutu Sese Seko, Idi Amin Dada, Robert Mugabe, Sani Abacha, and the likes. In moving forward, the branch shall later this month launch a memorandum on the Land Use Charge 2018 already submitted to the House of Assembly and hold a citizens' rally on it to afford the masses an opportunity to read and digest same and understand the reason why we dismiss the land use charge as a fraud. Wither Nigeria 2019. Elections in Nigeria have an ugly and persistent history of wide-scale violence leading to huge losses of life and destruction of properties. Nigerian politicians since the 1950s, even before independence, always waxed desperate in their attempt to win elections and to gain political posts and ascendancy. 2019 is another general election year, and the signs are already ominous that another macabre dance of death and destruction is about to start, if not already begun. Just last week, the World Congresses and primaries of the All Progressive Party, the ruling APC, ended in confusion and chaos as thugs of politicians, political warlords, disrupted activities for only just one reason, that their principle must not lose out. The alarm and the scare is that if mere inter-party conflict and dispute involve so much recklessness, won't it be a total conflagration when it becomes inter-party contest? Even more worrisome is that all the violence and disruption took place in the presence of security agents and personnel of the state who contrived to present a picture of helplessness and complacence. The MBA Ikeja branch hereby warns that Nigerian politicians are, by their desperation for political offices and loot, they are putting Nigeria into the danger of massive bloodletting and utter anarchy. What's most unfortunate in the mad and murderous scramble for power of Nigerian politicians is not for the interest of the masses, but for their own private gain and enrichment. We call on all well-meaning Nigerians, especially all progressive forces, to speak out against the wild and violent orientation of our politicians. We cannot leave politics only to the politicians. I will extrapolate here. There have been some criticism of this branch by some colleagues and non-colleagues of our intervention in national matters and state matters, to the point of saying lawyers ought to content themselves with filing motions in court and challenging authorities by way of judicial intervention alone. But that cannot be true. Like you have said before, the patron saint of this particular branch, Shepherd Williams, 142 years ago, around about 1868, said, "The lawyer lives for the direction of his people and advancement of his society." Leaving the field to the politicians is folding our arms and getting our house burnt in our very before. The court is a way of protest, but that's not the only way. Only last week I saw bishops on the road with their episcopal robes. Somebody should have told them that you can only stand in the pulpit and not in the road. But when your father, when your mother, when your wives, when your sisters, when your daughters, when your children are regularly, routinely, whimsically, capriciously killed, exterminated, murdered, and the state folds its hand, you just have to rise and do something. The NBA in Kenya, historically, does not have the tradition of folding its hands. We are not bread and tea butter lawyers. We are not mercantilist lawyers only. This branch, rightly so, prides itself as the conscience of the Nigerian Bar Association. And we'll do all that is possible under my watch, before my watch, after my watch, to protect, promote the interests of the Nigerian people against their savage leaders. And so to this end, the Tiger Bar, that is our branch, shall stage a walk to protest growing political violence in this country in the last week of May. I invite the drones to follow us. God willing, all progressive forces, whether you are lawyers, whether you are market women, whether you are artisans, you are cordially invited. I thank you all for your kind attention.